Russia?
I'm speaking at a conference here called Rails Club.
Rails Club. Sounds very exclusive.
Yes.
And elitist.
Yeah, it's a that's a strange name. I asked the conference organizers, I'm like, how did you get this name? And they said, well, we actually got it by mistake. I registered rubyconf.ru and I registered railsclub.ru and he put up the website for rubyconf.ru on the wrong domain.
Yep. Awesome.
So, and, yeah, I just stuck with it.
It's Rails Club.
Yep.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess let's do
all
it.
Right. So, all right, let's do it. So my name is John Mark Walker. We're here today with Aaron Patterson, coming at you live from Russia. How you doing, Aaron?
Yes, I'm in Moscow. I'm good. How are you doing?
So we're here chatting today about ManageIQ and cloud management and Rails, Ruby on Rails and Ruby, and what Aaron's going to be talking about at the Design Summit coming up on October 7th and 8th. Aaron, why don't you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about, you know, who you are and why should we care?
Sure. My name's Aaron Patterson. Most people on the internet know me by the name Tenderlove.
Why is that? Can you explain that to me?
Sure. all this is being blogged, right? Okay.
Yes, it is.
So... All right, so I was one day I was hanging out with some friends, a few girlfriends, and one of them says, you know, they just started the conversation, they're like, so what is the grossest thing a guy can say to you? And my one friend says, the grossest thing is he can say, I want to make tender love to you. And I just died. I was laughing so hard. So I registered the domain name tenderlovemaking.com, and I sent her a link the next day. I was like, check out this website. And she was like, no, I'm not checking it out. So I just made the whole, making this a completely technical blog. And she's like, ah. So the whole thing was basically just to troll my friend.
That's awesome. And it just stuck.
Yes, it just
That's fantastic. Okay, that's just something that I've been wondering ever since I saw your name come across. So now I know, and I feel I don't feel
like yes, it, you know.
But anyway,
I requested the alias Tenderlove at redhat.com. It has not gone through yet.
Do let us know when it does, because I'll make sure to add that to my my speed email list. All right, so okay, so now that out of the way, let's moving on to maybe more salient topics. What are you doing with the ManageIQ team, and what's your main job function there?
Sure. So I just a little background on me. I'm on the Rails core teams and also the Ruby core teams. And I'm on the ManageIQ team, and I'm working with them. What we're doing is, so my job on the team is basically to take all the stuff, like we have a bunch of patches against Rails, so get all that stuff pushed upstream, and make sure that we're running on a non-fork versions of Rails. So that's basically what I'm focused on right now.
And that's great, because carrying those changes forward can be such a bear over time. You know, I can understand why developers make that decision in the short term, not realizing in the long term just how much effort is just to keep it up to date. In fact, I got an article coming out about how having proprietary products actually leads you down that path. But anyway, I'm glad someone tackling that.
Yeah, it's hard because, I mean, we do have, like, I don't know, it's incredibly difficult for us to upgrade Rails on this application, mainly because of all these custom patches, since upstream has changed so much, like, getting these ported forward is not easy. So, anyway, that's what I'm working on for the team right now.
So just a question about your background. How long have you been like kind of a Ruby on Rails and a Ruby guy?
So I released my first Ruby gem in 2005.
Okay.
I've been on the Ruby core team and the Rails core team for maybe, I want to say, 4 or 5 years now. So while
it's funny because, I guess,
go ahead.
Oh, no, sorry. No, please continue. I was just going to say that Ruby guys in general have kind of maybe it's not quite earned. There's an association of Ruby guys of being a particular type. And I'm thinking like Ruby guys kind of get typecast as the loopy creative types who aren't necessarily writing enterprise class software. do you think that's what do you think of that characterization?
I think it's not, I don't know. I think it's not unwarranted, but I have to tell you, like, I mean, I actually came from an enterprise world. Please don't tell anybody this, but I used to be a JCVE developer. Like, don't.
No. Wow. Okay. Because they had the complete opposite, you know. All right. Your secret's safe with me.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. I've worked on the previous companies where I've worked. I mean, we've worked on extremely high traffic Rails websites. And I mean, some developers do write enterprise code, but I mean, I can definitely see coming from the J2EE world, like looking at the Ruby on Rails world and being like, wow. What is going on?
and yet you went in full force. Like, you didn't just dip your toe in. I mean, you became, you know, the guy.
Yeah. Yes. Well, I mean, I love dynamic languages. I used to do it. So before I was a J2E developer, I was doing Perl. And I love doing Perl, and just, I had to switch to Java, and I was a J2E developer for maybe 6 years or so. I kept saying, like, okay, I was like, Perl 6 is going to come any day, going to be here. And then I don't have to do this Java stuff anymore. And like,
yeah, we're still waiting for that, by the way. Just,
yes.
Yeah, no,
so I was going to say, that's how I found Ruby. Is like, a friend of mine was like, oh, check this out. So I started programming it, and I was like, this is what Perl 6 is supposed to be. I don't have to wait anymore. So that's how I got started. Really,
that's an interesting thought. I wonder if that's why no one really cares about Perl 6 anymore, because they have Ruby and Ruby on Rails.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I really have no idea. I haven't put much thought into it these days. I love Ruby so much. It's like,
Right. Yeah. So you don't need anything else. And so I also wanted to talk about, because I know we don't have a whole lot of time, but we're coming up quickly in about a week and a half, the first ever ManageIQ Design Summit. And so I'm assuming that you're going to be talking about some similar topics when you're there.
Yeah. While I'm there, I'm going to be talking about how we're going to get from, like, basically how we're going to get from Rails 3.2 up to 4 and then eventually up to Edge using Edge Rails. So, I'm just going to be talking about my work, basically. So, you know.
How long do you think it'll take to get us there?
I don't know. It's hard for me to say right now because, I mean, I've only been working at Red Hat now for a couple weeks, so I'm not totally familiar with the code, but from the patches that I've seen, maybe it'll take you can't make me put a number on this. This is open source, man. It ships when it ships.
It ships when it's ready and not a moment before. Yeah.
It'll take some time. I mean, like, I've got a handle on. So we've got a fork of Rails, and I've been looking through all those patches, and working through those isn't going to be too difficult. It's the I'm starting to discover code where we're manipulating Rails, but it's not in our fork. It's like outside of the fork. They've like basically monkey patch Rails that have other functionality. So that's the stuff that I'm kind of afraid of, is like finding that particular stuff. But getting all that pushed upstream shouldn't be too bad, I don't think. But we also have stuff like, for example, Rails has dropped support for RJS, a feature of Rails. I don't know if you know, but it's one feature of Rails, and we don't support it anymore. But the ManageIQ project makes heavy use of that feature. So we have to figure out how we're going to move that forward. So that's one of the challenges.
Okay. I look forward to hearing about all the great progress. So I want to end this on a controversial note. Hope you're ready.
Sure. Yep.
You're familiar with OpenStack and the Horizon interface?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know it uses Python Django?
Yes, I do.
What do you think about that? Should they just go to Rails? I mean, come on.
Oh, I don't know. So we were actually at my last job, we worked on a Rails front end for OpenStack. And I mean, I have to say, I liked it better.
I'm just going to be controversial.
Awesome. Just go with Rails. Just do it.
You go. was that work ever released? Did that ever see the light of day, or was it kept private? I'm curious now.
So it was Well, I mean, we shipped it, but it was an internal project, so the code was never open source or anything. So
okay. Bummer. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. All right. It is a bummer.
Excellent. Okay.
But go with Rails.
Everyone, go with Rails. Yes. Well said. All right. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you for coming by. I know you're really busy over in Moscow, so I really appreciate you taking the time. And I'm astounded the hotel Wi-Fi stood up as well as it did. I'm really pleasantly surprised by that. So you can see Aaron and a whole lot of other people. You can see Aaron and a whole lot of other people coming up on October 7th and 8th at the ManageIQ Design Summit in beautiful Mahwah, New Jersey. Check out the website manageiq.org, and you'll see a link on how you can register. And thanks for coming by. Glad to have you.
Thank you very much.
All right. Take care now.
All right. Talk to you later.